Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. I am delighted to announce that HitFilm 2021.2, also known as version 17, is now out. And in this video, I'm going to tell you everything that you need to know about it. New major features. Number 1, proxies. Simply put, a proxy video is essentially a smaller copy of a high-resolution raw footage video. By using a proxy video, you will have a much smaller file size to use during your editing process, making very large video files much more manageable for editing. Essentially, this feature will make for a much smoother editing experience without the choppy lag that you may have seen before. When opening HitFilm, simply select whether you want your proxies to be geared towards performance, quality, or no proxies at all. Also, you can control everything regarding proxies under File, Options, Proxies and Renders. Number 2, Timeline Cache. Timeline Cache is very similar to the RAM Preview feature previously found in HitFilm. The Timeline Cache feature allows for real-time playback on both the editor timeline and in composite shots. In addition, the cache is saved when a project is saved, so you won't lose this benefit when closing HitFilm. The nice part is that it happens automatically, or you can make it happen by clicking on the Create Timeline Cache button. Please note that this replaces the RAM Preview button in composite shots, so therefore there is no longer RAM Preview available. Number 3, FBX Animated Camera. This new feature for HitFilm Pro enables the ability to both import and export animated camera data in the FBX file format. Cameras animated in other 3D software such as Unreal or Blender can now be imported into HitFilm, and cameras in HitFilm can be exported for use in other 3D software as well. Number 4, Blackmagic RAW File Import. There is now support for Blackmagic BRAW files in both HitFilm Express and HitFilm Pro. Number 5, Mocha HitFilm Update. In both HitFilm Pro and HitFilm Express, Mocha HitFilm has been updated to continue providing the highest quality of features and benefits that Mocha can provide. Number 6, Super Glow Effects. HitFilm Pro now comes with a new set of glow effects called Super Glow. The Super Glow effect is essentially an improved version of HitFilm's existing glow effect, but uses a more organic falloff, reducing the need to stack multiple glows on top of each other, as well as more controls for extra customization of the hotspot, glow, tint, chromatic aberration, and even grain. Super Glow can be found under the Lights and Flares folder in HitFilm Pro. Do yourself a favor and spend some time playing with these. Number 7, the Cosmos Effect. The Cosmos Effect can be used to create animated starfield matrices with interconnecting lines for constellation-style visuals. The Cosmos Effect can be found under the Generate Effects folder in HitFilm Pro. Number 8, the Electro Effect. The Electro Effect can be used to create animated circuit board type visuals for Tron-like effects. The Electro Effect can also be found under the Generate Effects folder in HitFilm Pro. Number 9, the Page Curl Effect and Page Turn Transition. The new Page Curl Effect and Page Turn Transition provide customizable animated page turn effects for storybook-style storytelling. The Page Curl Effect can be found under the Warp Effects folder, and the Page Turn Transition can be found under the Video Transitions folder. These effects are included in both HitFilm Pro and HitFilm Express. New Added Enhancements. Number 1, Improvements in Text. The Text 360 Degree Text and Credits Crawl and Pulp Sci-Fi Title Crawl 2D effects have all been improved to use the same fonts and layout as text clips and layers. Number 2, Improvements to Scopes. A playback update checkbox has been added to the scopes panel. Unchecking this so that scopes are not updated during playback will greatly improve your playback performance. Number 3, Freehand Mask Tool Improvements. The Freehand Mask Tool has been improved so that a mask will only be closed if the first point is clicked while the last point is selected, or vice versa. A mask will not be closed if any other point is selected and the first point is clicked. That allows you to move that first point around. Also, a mask can now be closed or reopened at any time when the Freehand Mask Tool is selected by using the new closed menu item. Number 4, GoPro Lens Reframe Effect Viewer UI Improvements. The viewer UI for the GoPro Lens Reframe Effect now matches the UI for the original Adobe After Effects plugin. Number 5, Open in Trimmer. Open in Trimmer will now open a clip in the trimmer to the same frame as the playhead if the playhead is over that clip on the timeline. Also, the shortcut Control T has been added for opening timeline clips in the trimmer. Where has this been my whole life? Number 6, new keyboard shortcuts. When using the Track Select tool, you can now hold down the Alt key to select all the clips which are to the right of but not under the cursor. Also, when using the Track Select Back tool, holding down the Alt key selects all clips which are to the left of but not under the cursor. In addition, new keyboard shortcuts have been added for the Zoom In, Zoom Out, and Scale to Fit actions. Oh. Be still my heart. I'm Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel, and these are the newest updates to HitFilm 2021.2. What do you think of these updates? Which one is your favorite? Leave me a comment below and be part of the conversation. I would love to hear from you. Also, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss a thing. Videos come out weekly. Until next time, thanks for watching.